Here you have a DSD triangle. This triangle is to help you to remember how to calculate the distance traveled, speed, and the time taken. Okay, if you want to find the distance, speed and time, they are next to each other. So in this case, we will take speed times time. If you want to find the time taken, distance and speed, one on the top, another at the bottom. So this is divide. Distance divided by speed. If you want to find the speed, distance on the top, time at the bottom here. So this is divide, speed equal to distance divided by time. Okay, let's see some questions. How do you use this one to help us get the answers? Sometimes you may forget which one you have to place on the top and which one you have to place at the bottom here. So just remember the sequence for the alphabets. D comes first, followed by S, followed by T, right? Okay, so that you will remember D, S, T. Okay, let's see some questions. A motorcycle travels 1,800 meters in 2 minutes. Calculate the speed of the motorcycle in kilometer per hours. Kilometer per hours. So be careful, here is minutes speed. Okay, let me use another color. Speed is equal to distance divided by time, right? Okay, distance here is 1,800 meter divided by time, 2 minutes. But you need to be careful because the questions ask you to express your answer, give your answer in kilometer per hours. So means that this one we have to change become kilometer, and this one we have to change it become hours. 1 kilometer is equal to 1,000 meters. Kilometers change to meters, you have to multiply by 1,000. If you go opposite way, meters want to change it to kilometers, you have to divide it by 1,000. Okay, so here I want to change become kilometers. I need to divide it by 1,000. Now I will get kilometer here. Divided by the time taken. This is minutes, and the question is asking for hours. 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So hours change to minutes, you have to times 60. Minutes change to hour, you have to divide it by 60. Okay, so the 2 minutes I want to change become hours. 2 divided by 60, then it become hours. Okay, so the next step, you just press the calculator, 1,800 divided by 1,000, 1, 2, 3, 1.8 kilometer, and 2 divided by 60, okay, you get a very long decimal, so you change it become a fraction, you will get 1 over 30 hours. Okay, just press the calculator, 1.8 divided by 1 over 30. So the answer will be 54 kilometer per hours. Okay, so this is the answer for A. Now we go to B. The time taken in minutes. So the units here is very important. You have to be more careful. The time taken in minutes for the journeys of 6 kilometers. We want to find the time taken. Time taken equal to distance divided by speed. Okay, so time taken equal to distance divided by speed. So the distance here is 6 kilometers, 6 kilometers, divided by the speed. The speed here is 54 kilometers per hour. 54. So look, be careful of the units. Here is kilometer. So this is kilometer also, no problem. But when you take 6 divided by 54, because this is hour, the answer that you get is not in minutes, it's in hours. So in order to change these numbers, these final answers in hours to minutes, what do we have to do? Hours to minutes, you have to times 60. Then it becomes minutes. Okay, so just press the calculator. 6 times 60 divided by 54. Okay, you can give your answers in 6.67 minutes, or you change it become a fraction, then it will be 6 and 2 over 3 minutes. Okay, let's go to the question number 2. Windy drive from town A to town B with an average speed of 70 kilometers per hour for 2.5 hours. He spent 30 minutes less for the return trip. Calculate the average speed for of the return trips. Okay, let me just see this sketch diagram for you. So now you have town A, you have town B. Okay, let me draw the DSD triangle over here, so easier for you to remember how to get the distance, speed, and the time. Okay, so now we have town A, town B. We need travel from town A to town B with a speed of 7 km per hour for 2.5 hours. Okay, so he spent 30 minutes less for the return trips. Calculate the average speed of the return trips, so average speed. First things, you need to know what information that you are looking for, what information that you need. Average speed. Speed is equal to distance divided by time. So it's total distance travel divided by total time taken. Okay, so now we need to find out the total distance travel and the total time taken. Okay, so from A to B, the speed using here is 70 km per hour, travel for 2.5 hours. So what is the distance between A and B? You want to find the distance. Distance equal to speed times times, right? So the distance between town A and town B is equal to speed times time. So look at the units, very important. This is per hours, this is also hours, so no problem. 1 hour 70 kilometers. So 2.5 hours. 70 times 2.5 is actually 2.5 hours. So when you multiply, then you will get kilometer. How many kilometer here? 70 times 2.5. Okay, so now we know the distance between town A and town B is 175 kilometers. So we have no problem for this part. Now we have the value. Okay, the next thing is to figure out the time taken here. When Windy drive from B to A, go return the return trips, the time taken here is 30 minutes less for 30 minutes less compared with A to B. So this is 2.5 hours. 2.5 hours. It means 2 hours plus 1/2 hours, right? So this 2 hours, no problem. 1 over 2 hours, if you want it to convert become minutes, you have to times 60. Then it become minutes. So it's 2 hours. So this is 30 minutes. Okay, so we know that from A to B is 2 hours and 30 minutes, right? So from B, go back to A. 30 minutes lesser. So we take 2 hours, 30 minutes minus 30 minutes, then you will get 2 hours. Correct? Okay, so this will be the average speed. Take 175 divided by 2. The average speed is 87.5 kilometer per hour. Okay, so this is the final answer for these questions.